Good evening. I'll have everybody take your seat here in just a moment. Good evening. We decided to call an audible and start the proceedings a little bit earlier. I want to welcome all of y'all. My name is Alan Lang. I'm the editor of Y'all Politics, who is one of the sponsors of the event here this evening, along with Super Talk Mississippi. Before we get going in earnest for our presentation, I'm going to ask my friend Bishop Ronnie Crudup of New Horizons Church International to come bless us with an invocation.
Good evening. Good evening. Father, how wonderful it is that we can approach your throne. Your word says that we can approach the throne of grace with confidence to find grace and mercy to help in our times of need. On this day, after our national election, Lord, we pray for the United States of America. Thank you that America is a great country. It is a collection of wonderful people. And Lord, we pray your blessings on America, upon its people, upon our government, upon our new president-elect, and all who will work with him in this cabinet, and upon this country as the process of politics goes forward. Thank you for politics and political expression. Thank you that we live in a place like this, Lord, where we can differ, Lord, and yet be civil. Thank you that in this room tonight, we celebrate really good people who make a tremendous difference, who give of themselves, Lord, to make the common good. We pray tonight especially for our honorees, for Senator Cochran. Thank you for him. And we speak the blessings, the grace of Jesus Christ upon him. Oh God, continue to use him. We pray for Governor Winner, and thank you for him. We speak the grace of Jesus Christ upon him. We pray, God, that you will continue to bless him. Thank you for good long life that he has lived. Continue to bless both of these men and their families, God, in a special way. But we also pray, God, for all of those who are politicians, our governor here, and so many others. Oh God, be with them and all of the business leaders. And once again, make Mississippi the great state that we know it can be, where there is no fear. But there's a lot of fear and anxiety in America today. But help us to be a shining star. What is possible as we come together to make life better? Bless food and drink, all that goes forth this night. And my prayer is in Christ's name. Amen. Amen.
Thank you, Bishop Crudup. That was a blessing fit for the top 50, I must say. It's been an interesting week. You all look well rested. It's been an interesting night. But if I can give it some perspective, last Wednesday night, after 108 years, the Chicago Cubs came back from a 3-1 deficit on the road
Thank you. On the road, in extra innings, after a rain delay, and broke a 108-year curse. 2 days later, 5 million people flooded the streets of Chicago in what has been termed the largest gathering of humanity in United States history. 2 days ago, we had rain for the first time in 57 days. And last night, what most people, even his most ardent supporters, believed to be impossible, Donald Trump is now the president-elect of the United States. Whether you are scratching your head, praying your rosary, crying in your beer, or celebrating with the finest champagne, I think we can all agree this has been one of the most improbable weeks in United States history. But here we are, and as for the Mississippi Top 50 Award, we're overwhelmed with the response both from the public and from the awardees. This has been an interesting endeavor, and y'all are all gracious enough to be here tonight. We're here first of all to honor the folks that have been honored in the Mississippi Top 50. I'm not going to make you stand up. I'm not going to make you come up here. You're all stars. We could spend all night doing that. But more importantly, we're here to recognize our Hall of Fame honorees, Senator Thad Cochran and Governor William Winter. This portion of the evening is graciously sponsored by our friends at Capital Resources and Tower Loan, which we'll talk about in just a moment. But if you'll allow me a personal aside, it is hard to believe that this is the 13th year of Y'all Politics' continuous daily operation, much to my wife's chagrin. We started, thank you. Since we started back in 2004, we've seen a lot of things come and go, a lot of political characters, a lot of media outlets, and a lot of websites and other media. And much like this particular Top 50 Award, Y'all Politics really started by accident. It was started on the premise of using the internet to democratize information. I kind of believe that there is a segment of people out there that don't want to read a few column inches or read a 90-second or watch a 90-second TV package about a bill or a finance report or a politician's speech. They want to see it for themselves, unfiltered, with all the cards laying face up on the table. And that's what we've endeavored to done. That's what we've endeavored to do. And if you'll indulge me, Y'all Politics has spawned a successful book. We've disseminated tens of thousands of pages of public documents. We've been cited in dozens of online and print media, including the Wall Street Journal, NBC News, TPM, and just about every TV station, print, and online publication in the state of Mississippi. And we've been quietly cussed by dozens of political spouses as that darn y'all website. But on our site, we've generated over 50 million page views over the years and generated millions of more pages, or millions of more impressions in social media. But I think more importantly, we've helped inform the public in a way that no one else has. As for the Top 50 Awards themselves, there's certainly a lot of different ways that you could decipher who is the most influential in the state of Mississippi. But the way that we came about it is this. If you wanted to get something done in Mississippi, who are the top 50 people that you would want to conscript in that endeavor? They're not all politicians, they're not all business leaders, they're not all lobbyists, they're not all media people. It's a mix of both, or a mix of all of the above. And they're folks from all over the state. What we decided to do was to hold an open nominations period online. And for 6 weeks, we received almost 200 nominations from around the state. A group of nameless, faceless people who you will never know locked ourselves in a room, a group of bipartisan folks, and we came up with this list. And I'm really, really proud of the end result. I think this is representative of Mississippi politically, demographically, geographically. I think we really, really did well. And we wanted to create an event this evening that was worthy of the list. And the end result is here. It's you. We wanted something a little less like a rubber chicken dinner and something a little bit more like a tailgate party. And whether you're at the Junction or the Grove or the Rock or any other venue in Mississippi, I think what we do here tonight, what we did here for a couple of hours, we do better than anybody in the country. If you could bottle what we do here, you could be rich. People envy this. It's part of our culture. And this is what we wanted to have here this evening. And so you're all a part of that, and I'm very appreciative of it. When we first came up to the idea, I talked to four individuals. I talked to Steve Davenport and Kim Dillon at SuperTalk. And since we'd worked together well over the years, I just thought it was a natural fit. They instantly said yes and became a title sponsor. The other two people I talked to were Henry Barber and Frank Lee. Henry Barber of Capital Resources and Frank Lee of Tower Loan. And together we came up with the Hall of Fame Awards, which again, they've graciously agreed to sponsor. As a few of you may remember, when we first started this, we had intended to call this part of the award Emeritus. And after a little bit, I got a little feedback that said, that's probably not the right idea, that you probably want to call it the Hall of Fame, because people who have influence continue to have influence. And nobody embodies that tonight like our two honorees. So they are, in fact, in the Hall of Fame because they'd never not be on the list. So without further ado, we're honoring, I think probably if you could pick two people in the state of Mississippi, you could not combine two people that have had more impact on this state in the last half century. And our first honoree this evening is Senator Thad Cochran. Aside from his individual accomplishments, which are way too numerous to list, I think one of the legacies of a good leader are those that have worked for him and have gone on to do good in the world. When people think back on the leaders in the state, I don't think there's anyone that has generated more impactful leadership from his office than Senator Cochran. And to illustrate that to you, I'm going to let some folks that have worked for him come introduce him tonight. So I'm going to introduce Keith Hurd, who is his current chief of staff, Dr. Mark Keenum, his former chief of staff, and now president of Mississippi State University, Haley Fisackerly, who's CEO of Entergy Mississippi, and Mayo Flint, president of AT&T Mississippi.
Well, this is quite a crowd we have here tonight, and it's, I know this is a bipartisan event, but it damn well feels good to be a Republican today. The only problem is we've caught the car, and now we got to govern. And we've got a man that we're honoring tonight that's going to be, has what it takes to do what's needed. Is that working now? What a great evening this has been. And thank you, Alan, and y'all politics for, and thanks Steve Davenport and SuperTalk for putting this together, developing the Mississippi Top 50. And we appreciate the service that your organizations, both of your organizations, are doing for the state of Mississippi. And it's my pleasure to talk about the first honoree to be inducted. I'm sorry, people, this thing kind of drifts on me. How's that? It's my pleasure to talk about the first honoree to be inducted into the Mississippi Top 50 Hall of Fame, Thad Cochran. This is an honor, and I appreciate it. First, I'd like to recognize Thad's family. We have Clayton Cochran is here with his daughter, Lizzie. Would y'all please stand? Lizzie is named after Thad's grandmother. And I'd also like to recognize Kay Weber Cochran, Thad's wife and soulmate. It's also good to be up here with other members of the top 50, Mark, Haley, and Mayo. All of us have been staff to Senator Cochran, in my case, twice. I think it speaks volumes of Thad Cochran that four of his staff made the first Mississippi Top 50. Just think, if you include Thad, we represent 10% of this class. And with Thad on board, we really represent more than that. Now, that's a high number, and if you include others on the list that are part of the Cochran family or the Cochran network, the number would be even higher. But 10% directly tied to Senator Cochran. Senator Cochran has had a great impact on all of our lives. Mayo said he would not be where he is today without having worked for TC. He took Mark from academia, brought him to Washington, cleaned him up, gave him a little sophistication, and now look at him. Not only is he the best president that Mississippi State has ever had, he's also the president of the Southeastern Conference. Now that's power. He plucked me off a tractor, put me on the road, and then he brought me to D.C. twice. And I don't know where the hell he got Haley. No, seriously, Haley is a good old farm boy like me, and he and Mayo do a great job for their companies, for Entergy and AT&T. So it's just wonderful to be up here. Thank you. And so, Thad, from the four of us, we just like to say thank you. And we speak for the rest of your staffers. You make us proud to say we work for Thad Cochran. Because once a Thad Cochran staffer, you always want to be one, and you always are. Thank you, Thad Cochran. Now that dedication, it goes across Capitol Hill. I can tell you without a shadow of a doubt, Thad Cochran is one of, if not the most, respected and loved members of the United States Senate. Not that they're a very lovable bunch. But from the Capitol Hill police, to the elevator operator, to the committee staff, to the senators, to the leaders, he is respected. And that goes for Democrats as well. I love it when a Democratic staffer or a Democratic senator tells me what a fine man Thad Cochran is. That he is good to work with, and you can take him at his word. Sounds kind of quaint, doesn't it? Well, it's not, because that is the way it is supposed to work. We have a country to run. The founding fathers did not set our country up to be shut down. And Thad Cochran is at the forefront of making our government run as chairman of the Senate Appropriations Committee. They call Thad the quiet persuader, and that's because he gets things done. Well, the only thing I can tell you, as can my three colleagues here, that Thad Cochran ain't always quiet. It's not good to be on the opposite sides of a discussion with Thad. Sometimes you just have to buckle up and hang on. Because he stands forward and moves forward. He gets things done. Thad gets things done because he's principled. He takes his position and fights for it, especially if it's for Mississippi. He gets things done because of his integrity. Everyone knows he is trying to do something for the right reason. And he gets things done because of his character. People want to help Thad Cochran because he treats everyone the same, with the respect that all human beings should have for each other. That's the Thad Cochran that I know, and that's the one that you know. I'm not going to list all the things that Thad has done for Mississippi over the years. Y'all know that. I'm not going to talk about how he keeps America safe by supporting our military. And even other countries such as Israel, who credit Thad Cochran as the father of the Iron Dome that protects that country from being destroyed and has been doing that for over 20 years. I'm not going to talk about his importance to the agricultural economy, the medical industry, and the infrastructure in this country. We all know that. What Thad Cochran has done is legendary. I just wanted to focus on the man, the fine man that he is, the Boy Scout that went to the top in a rough and tumble world, rough and tumble business, politics, a fighter who doesn't quit. I present to you the senator's senator, the citizen leader, the first inductee to the Mississippi Top 50 Hall of Fame, Thad Cochran.
Thank you very much. Thank you so much. Such a flattering introduction and presentation, Keith Hurd. Thank you very, very much. Where is Oktok? That's close where he is in the Mississippi Prairie, and one of the most effective staff members in Washington today. We're lucky he's working for Mississippi as well as the federal government. Let me tell you that I wrote down just a couple of lines, and I want to read it so I won't get it messed up. Thank you very much for this special honor. I deeply appreciate the recognition. And it is also something that makes me feel warm-hearted to know that William Winter is being honored in a similar way tonight, and no one has greater respect in Mississippi politics and as a person than William Winter. It has been my sincere pleasure to represent Mississippi's interests in our federal government, both as a congressman and as a United States senator. It is a high honor, which I take very seriously. But I look forward to continuing to work with you to the best of my ability. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Senator Cochran. Next, it's my high honor to set the stage for our second Hall of Fame nominee on the most vexing problems that have faced our state, namely racial reconciliation and educational attainment. I don't think there's anybody, certainly in the last half century, that's had more impact on that than Mississippi Governor William Winter. And like Senator Cochran, Governor Winter's legacy also includes generating influential leaders in both government and the private sector. To introduce Governor Winter this evening, please welcome his former press secretary and clerk of the U.S. District Court in Oxford, Mr. David Cruz.
Good Good evening.
Whoa, maybe I better tone it down. I need to start off, Senator Cochran, thanking you and your staff on behalf of the United States District Court in the Northern District of Mississippi up in God's country. Glenn McCullough, do you agree with that? For your just a stalwart help in for our court at so many levels, and most importantly and impressively for us lately, helping us secure that new United States courthouse, which we're just now starting to work on. If we can get that final authorization, we've got the appropriations, we just need the final authorization.
You cannot lobby from the podium.
I have to, because my judges are after me to get started on that courthouse. But we appreciate it so much, both you, Senator Cochran, and Senator Wicker, for your making that happen, because it wouldn't have happened without you. Now, 2 years ago, I came up with this notion that I wanted to produce a documentary film on William Winter. And so I did, and it aired on Mississippi Public Broadcasting. Now, I named the film The Toughest Job. And folks of you out there from the 1967 campaign, like Mr. Joe Sanderson, and those of you on the 1975 campaign, and those of you on the 1979 campaign know, getting William Winter elected governor of Mississippi is just about the toughest job there is. Now, that title reflects a lot more than just those three runs for governor. But governor, that was the toughest job for so many of us. A few years ago, shortly after Governor Winter left the governor's office, he ran into a gentleman on the street, stuck out his hand and said, "I'm William Winter." The man looked at Governor Winter rather puzzled and said, "Goodness gracious, Governor, I thought you were dead." Winter responded, "Well, perhaps not. Well, only politically." So here we are, 30 years after that premature diagnosis, and Governor Winter is still going strong, working every day to improve and strengthen our state and our nation, tackling so many tough and unpopular issues that face our nation. 2 weeks ago, Governor Winter won the Freedom Award from the National Civil Rights Museum. I was fortunate enough to attend that. It was a sold-out event at the Cannon Center in Memphis. A gentleman was seated next to me. He asked me why I was there, and I said, "Well, I'm here to witness Governor Winter receiving this award." And when I mentioned that Governor Winter is 93 years old, the gentleman asked, "Well, who's going to be accepting this award for him?" I smiled and said, "Well, just watch this." Moments later, Governor Winter bounded up on stage like a 25-year-old, and he delivered an impassioned, rousing oration about the importance of harmony and understanding and having the fortitude to take on the tough, vexing issues facing our nation. True leadership is no sport for the short-winded. In William Winter and Thad Cochran, we have two fine, talented, accomplished leaders who have been at it for the long haul. Our state is blessed to have them both pitching in for Mississippi and our nation year after year, decade after decade. They are an example of the best in our nation and in the best in our public discourse. William Winter has been at the forefront of issues of core importance to our state for 7 decades, 70 years. After service in the United States Army during World War II, as part of the Greatest Generation, Governor Winter was elected to the Mississippi Legislature while he's still in law school. I suspect most of us in the room here tonight were not even born when Governor Winter first entered public life. From an early age, early in his career, Governor Winter exhibited political courage and perhaps a measure of political foolhardiness when he ran for Speaker of the House, Speaker Gunn. He ran for Speaker of the House against the powerful House Speaker, Walter Sillars. While serving as state tax collector, collecting bootleg whiskey tax, some of which I guess is not here tonight, Governor Winter recommended abolishing the job. And it's rare for a politician to get rid of his own position, especially one as lucrative as the state tax collector's job. In fact, Time magazine noted that Governor Winter, then tax collector Winter, was the second highest paid public official in the United States, second only to Dwight Eisenhower. But Governor Winter did succeed in convincing the Mississippi legislature to abolish that position as a good government measure. During his first run for governor in 1967, the one that Joe Sanderson worked on, Winter's life was threatened by the Ku Klux Klan for its moderate stance on racial issues. Undeterred, Governor Winter continued to campaign from one end of the state to the other. We'd be here all night if I tried to relate all of his accomplishments, but as our governor from 1980 to 1984, Governor Winter worked doggedly and relentlessly to secure a package of education reforms, as Alan mentioned earlier, that brought kindergartens, compulsory school attendance, and other vital reforms to our state. Now, when my son discovered that I had worked for Governor Winter and worked with him on bringing compulsory school attendance to the state, my son was very upset about this. And he noted, he said, "You mean that if it wasn't for you and Governor Winter," I said, "not for me, for Governor Winter, I wouldn't have to go to school?" And I says, "Your mama says you're going to school no matter what, compulsory school attendance or no compulsory school attendance." It took three attempts and relentless grassroots effort for Governor Winter to get those education reforms passed. Amusingly, after passage of the bill, called the 1982 Education Reform Act, in discussing the white-hot pressures that he had received from the parents, from a number of parents interested in better education for their children, one legislator blurted out to the governor, "Governor, that's the last time I'm voting for a bill I'm against." For his courage and perseverance, Governor Winter won the John F. Kennedy Profiles in Courage Award several years ago. But what is perhaps most remarkable is that despite a remarkable career in politics, marked by fortitude and courage, despite his many accomplishments and prestigious awards like this tonight, Governor Winter has remained humble. Winston Churchill once described one of his parliamentary foes as an arrogant man with little to be arrogant about. It can, I think, truly be said of Governor Winter that he's a humble man with little to be humble about. Governor, come on up.
Thank you very much. Thank you so much. I'm asking myself, what in the world am I doing here tonight? But I'm grateful for being here, and I thank all of you who have been responsible for my being here, and I thank all of you for your friendship. I wish I could go around this room tonight and call by name everyone who has been helpful to me during my lifetime. So let me just say thank you for being my friend. I want to thank especially some of the folks that are gathered right here, my wife Elise and my granddaughter Caroline Gillespie. I want to thank David for not telling everything he knows about me. And Kathy Mangum, who keeps me straight on a daily basis. And all of my colleagues from the Jones Walker Law Firm, thank you for being here, and thank you for letting me continue to be associated with you. But the most satisfying aspect of my standing here tonight is that I stand here literally in the shadow of one of the greatest Mississippians I've ever known, and that is Senator Thad Cochran. You know, I have made a lot of mistakes, in my life. But the biggest one probably that I ever made was running against Thad for the United States Senate. But he taught me a very invaluable lesson. If you get ready to run for an office, for goodness sake, don't run against somebody you like, and don't run against somebody that everybody likes. So let me thank him for the contributions that he has made to the people of Mississippi. He has been a genuine statesman in a time when we don't have statesmen in every situation. And I do thank him for his friendship. And I'm going to maybe be a little presumptuous when I say this. I like to think that the relationship that I have with Thad Cochran, personal and political and otherwise, reflects the kind of friendship that should exist among all of us in public life. We don't have to be from the same party. We don't have to agree on every public policy. But we do have, I think, a responsibility to be civil with each other, to be friends, to respect each other, and to understand that we're all, I think it is accurate to say, trying to make this a better place for all of us. That is what public life ought to be about, to make things better for all of us, and to work together to achieve that. I was fortunate enough to grow up with a father who spent 24 years in the Mississippi legislature. And one among my earliest memories were coming to Jackson with him and watching the Mississippi legislature in session and saying to myself, you know, I would like to do that myself sometimes. My father taught me this. My father thought of politics as being a noble profession. I think of politics as being a noble profession. I think it ought to be held up to our younger people as being an activity worth involving oneself in. The practice of politics represents, I think, about the most important thing that could go on, because politicians make the decisions about the quality of life for all of us. All those decisions of war and peace, of how we get along with each other, of how we use our resources in an intelligent way. All of us have a stake in seeing to it that politics does not ever devolve into a process by which we look on each other with disdain and with disrespect. Let us have a political system consisting of two strong parties that will be a model, continue to be a model for the world. We have that opportunity. We elected a president of the United States yesterday. Let us make certain that the government of this country and the government of this state will be benefited by the records that president that we elected yesterday made. Let us help. You know, as a Democrat, I didn't vote for him, but I want him to be a successful president, and I want to do everything I can to help make him a successful president. That is how we maintain a great country. So let me end these remarks by thanking all of you for being my friends over the years, for making the contributions that you are making now to make this, to continue to make this the best state in the nation. I've lived in this state all my life. I wouldn't have wanted to live anywhere else. I'm proud of this state. I'm proud of the progress that we are making. And I think that the future is going to be better than the past, and it will be so when we have the kind of leaders like Thad Cochran who will make the tough decisions that enable us to achieve those goals. Thank you so much for letting me be here tonight.
Governor Winter, thank you so much. I think I speak on behalf of the room when I say to both you and to Senator Cochran that we are honored by your presence and we are grateful for your service to our state. Before we leave this evening, I just want to thank a few people. Again, certainly the sponsors, Y'all Politics, Supertalk Mississippi, and Capital Resources and Tarrellone, who sponsored this portion of the evening. I'd like to thank my selection committee, who will remain nameless and faceless. That is a result of some sage advice that I received to keep the search committee bipartisan, fair, and secret, because these political types love to work the refs. I'd like to thank Frank Quarter, who's here with us tonight, who's been working with us at Y'all Politics for going on 5 years and is a huge part of what we do at Y'all Politics, my staff at Kinetic Staffing, including Susan Newhouse, Kate Hurd, DLA Belcher, Catherine Breland, without whom I could not function. And I'd also like to thank my wife, Holly, who's here with us this weekend. And for those of you who have been around the Mississippi Book Festival, she is an ever constant presence there. So many of you know her through her many endeavors. And if you've not had a chance to view the awards themselves, I'd encourage you to come up and look at them. They were created by Elizabeth Robinson, who's a glass artist here with Spirit House Glass. They are exquisite. And to the honorees or to the awardees tonight, please make sure and come up and get them. We will do our best to get them to you, but it would obviously be better if you took them with you here. So, and you also might notice on the award, you might see an otherwise benign rendering of the Capitol that has a screaming eagle on the top, courtesy of Marshall Ramsey, who did our rendering there. So. As always, Bob Davidson and his band, who was with us this evening, Steve Patterson and Emil Wilson, who's helped us document the evening, and finally, the folks here at the Old Capitol Inn. This has been a tremendous event. Again, congratulations to the awardees. Thank you for being with us, and look forward next year to more information about the next Top 50. Until then, we have food and drink. We encourage you to stay if you would like, but until then, we stand adjourned. Thank you.